tell us that black men shall be slaves and white men shall be free. They nowhere make any distinction among men in respect to rights on account of color. They say, we the people, never we the white people.
Celebrating the African Spirit invited Paul Oakley Stovall, a Broadway actor who is now playing in the traveling company of Hamilton, because he is a student of Frederick Douglass.
Well, I was working on a Juneteenth project, and Chris Burney, who runs New York Stage and Film, his best friend was the producer, and I was a creative director and head writer, and Chris came down to the city. I've known Chris for years. He said, you're working on a Frederick Douglass thing? You know, something at Poughkeepsie, they're doing a Frederick Douglass thing. Let me see if they might want to, if you can be of any use. So I actually didn't know what I was getting myself into, because I'm really focused on that 1845. I'm becoming a Frederick scholar, but I needed to dig in to get the vibe for what was happening in 1858.
CAS, or Celebrating the African Spirit, is an organization that's dedicated to the research of the enslaved Africans of Poughkeepsie and their contributions to the economic foundation of Poughkeepsie. And in that journey, we have discovered several other important events. And one was that of Frederick Douglass coming to Poughkeepsie, New York on August the 2nd, 1858. And the people were thirsty for the information that he was about to bring them.
Just remember that though the church is mighty, the truth is mightier. And that however opposed and however delayed, the truth can never fail. That God and humanity, time and eternity, and silence and in thunder and in all the vicissitudes of existence will, in the end, see truth triumphant over all foes.
Frederick Douglass spoke for 2 hours at College Hill Park here in Poughkeepsie, and then from there he went to an enclosed building and spoke for another hour. His main message was what it is we have to do, what we have to fight for, what our philosophy has to be in order for us to overcome the horrors of slavery. And he was very articulate. 4,000 people came to see him, and as you know, in 1858, just about everything was word of mouth. And so it was really a fantastic occasion and a fantastic event.
Abraham Lincoln said, a house divided against itself cannot stand. I believe this government cannot endure permanently half slave and half free. I do not expect the Union to be dissolved. I do not expect the house to fall, but I do expect it will cease to be divided. It will either become all one thing or all the other. Either the opponents of slavery will arrest the further spread of it and place it where the public mind shall rest in the belief that it is in the course of ultimate extinction, or the advocates of slavery will push it forward.
I think Frederick is very popular right now. People are really into his words, and you just have to do the work. There's no easy solve. You have to do the work. You heard that speech. It could have been written yesterday, you know? So it's time to bring him back up. And as you bring him back up, so many things will open up. And you know, really today was kind of a go for it moment. It really was.
Everybody was very appreciative of the time and the energy that Paul Oakley Stovall gave to us in Poughkeepsie. And it was really extraordinary. It was motivational. It was inspirational. Man's an actor. He knows how to do it. And he did it exceptionally well.
Thank you, everyone.